This is how to make this MrBeast contestant flip animation in Premiere Pro. So inside the main sequence, you need to create another sequence for the YouTuber and the icon. So go to the project panel, right click and select new item, and then select sequence. You can now name the sequence YouTuber 1 or whatever you like. Now make sure you're inside the new composition and then go to the toolbar. Now to create this red stroke on the image, you need to click and hold on the rectangle tool and then select the ellipse tool. Now go to the screen and then hold shift while dragging to scale it evenly. Now for the flip animation to work properly, you need to align the shape to the middle of the screen, and you can hold control while dragging the shape to snap it to the center. Now go to effects controls and then expand the shape tab, and then under appearance disable the fill option and enable the stroke. You can now increase the stroke to around 40 and then change the color of the stroke to whatever you like, and then click on OK. Now to make this bevel on the circle like MrBeast, you need to go to the effects panel and then search bevel alpha. And if you're on a newer version of Premiere, you might not have this effect, so check out the video link in the description. Now apply the bevel alpha effect to the circle layer, and then in effects controls you can increase the edge thickness to around 9 and the light intensity to around 0.6. Now adding the YouTubers to the shape is the next step, so simply move the shape layer up one track and then drag the image of the person below it. Now make sure the YouTuber image is selected, and then in effects controls simply change the scale and the position so the face fits within the circle. Now to remove the rest of the image, under opacity click on the ellipse tool to create a circular mask. You can now hold shift to scale the mask evenly and move the mask inside the circle. And if you accidentally mess up and can't see the blue handles anymore, then you can simply click on mask 1 in effects controls, and then they should be visible again. To darken the profile picture and make it black and white, you need to open the Lumetri color tab, and if you don't have it, then go to window and then click on Lumetri color. Now make sure the image is selected, and then under the basic correction tab set the saturation to 0 to make it black and white, and then decrease the exposure as well to make the picture darker. Now to add some blur to the image, you can open the effects panel and then search Gaussian blur, and then apply the effect to the image layer, and in effects controls simply increase the blurness value to whatever you like. To create the actual flip animation, go to the project panel, click a new item, and then select adjustment layer, and then drag the adjustment layer over both layers in the timeline. Now go to the effects tab and then search basic 3D, and then apply the effect to the adjustment layer. Now with the layer selected, go to effects controls and then move to about the 1 second mark, and this is so that we have a bit of time to animate in the icons later on. Now click on the stopwatch next to swivel to create a keyframe, and then move forward to around the 2 second mark and then change the value to 180. We have now created this flip animation. To make the animation more fluid, you can select the keyframes, then right click, ease in, and then select ease out. To make the transition between the blurred and the unblurred icon smooth, you need to click on the arrow next to swivel to open up the speed graph. Now drag the left handle a bit to the right, and make sure to don't move this handle up or down, since that will mess up the animation, so you can press Ctrl and C to undo. And also move the right handle a bit to the left, so we get this peak at the middle of the graph. And this peak is where the animation is the fastest. And we're going to use this peak to transition to the other icon. And this is what we got so far. To create the transition, move the playhead so it aligns with the peak of the graph, and the icon is at the middle of its transition. And then in the timeline, make a cut on the image layer and the circle layer. Now select the image, and in effects controls, remove all the effects from the layer. And this is how the animation looks right now. Now you might notice that the final image is flipped horizontally. There's an easy way to fix this. Simply go to effects and then search flip, and then apply the horizontal flip effect to the image, and now the image is no longer flipped. Now to create this glow on the circle and the image, you first need to move the adjustment layer up 2 tracks and the shape layer up 1 track. To create the glow, we need to duplicate the layers, so hold Alt or Option and Mac and then drag the image layer up 1 track, and do the same thing with the shape layer. Now go to effects and then search Gaussian blur, and then apply the effect to the top image layer. Now with the layer selected, go to effects controls and then set the blend mode to screen, and then increase the blurness value to get this glow, and you can decrease the opacity to lower the intensity if you want. I move to the start of the clip and then click on a stopwatch next to blurriness to create a keyframe, and then move to about the 3-second mark and then reset the blurriness value. And this will create a slow fade out effect on the glow. Now to apply the same glow on the shape layer, you can select the Gaussian blur effect and then press Ctrl and C to copy it. Now select the top shape layer and then paste the effect by pressing Ctrl and V. And also make sure to select the top shape layer and then set the blend mode to screen. And this is what we got so far. Now we need to do the same thing with all the other YouTubers, but in a faster manner. So go to the project panel and then right click on the YouTuber sequence and then click on duplicate at the top. Now duplicate the sequences so that you have one for each YouTuber. And since I have 5 YouTubers, I will need 5 sequences in total. Now double click on the first copy of the sequence to open it. Now to replace the image of a YouTuber with a different image is pretty simple. Just select the image you want to replace it with in the project panel. Then select the 3 images in the timeline, right click, and then select replace clip with and then from bin. And there's actually a secret method of replacing the images in a faster way, and I will show it in a second. You will now see that the images are replaced, but if the images are different sizes and resolutions, it might mess up the position and the mask. To fix this, move to the first image and then select it. Now in effects controls, you might need to scale up the image and reposition it inside the circle. To fix the mask, you can click on mask 1 to show it, and then you can hold shift again while dragging to make the circle even. And just keep changing the size and the position of the mask until it fits perfectly. And to avoid doing the same process on the other 2 images, we can simply copy the settings. So click on opacity and then hold shift and then click on motion. Now press Ctrl and C to copy the settings. You can now select the 2 other images in the timeline and then paste the settings by pressing Ctrl and V. And you can now see that the images are the right size. One last thing you have to do is to select the top image layer and then change the blend mode back to screen to get this glow again. Now we need to repeat the steps with all the other sequences. Before I reveal the secret to replacing the images faster, you first need to double click to open the next sequence. Now to replace the images faster, you need to hold shift and then left click on the 3 images to select them, and then go to the project panel. Now click on your image and then hold alt or option on Mac and then drag your image onto the layers to replace it. And it's really important that you hold alt while dragging, otherwise it won't work. Now we have to fix the mask and reposition the image again. So move the player to the first image and then scale up and change the position of the picture. Then click on mask 1 and then hold shift to fix the mask. Now select the opacity and the motion effect and then copy them. Then select the other 2 images in the timeline and then paste the effects. And don't forget to select the top image layer and then change the blend mode to screen to get the glow. And now repeat this process with all the sequences and YouTubers. Now inside the main sequence, you can drag your first YouTuber sequence to the timeline. And then with the layer selected, go to effects controls and then scale down the image and reposition it so it's in the top right of the screen or wherever you want. Now to add other small images to the animation, you need to be inside one of the YouTuber sequences and then make sure you're at the start of the animation, where the image is dark and blurred out. Now click on this little camera icon to save the frame, and make sure import into project is checked. And then you can change the name if you want and click on OK. Then open the next sequence and move to a point where the image is blurred again, and then press on the camera. Then double check that import into project is checked and then click on OK. And repeat this with all the sequences. And the reason we are doing this is because we don't want the flip animation to happen on all the layers and only on one. So we're going to use this image of each sequence as a placeholder. Now in the project panel, you can shift select all images and then drag them above the sequence in the timeline. Now select the image above the sequence and then in effects controls change the scale value and make it smaller than the other image. And then change the position so the image is below it. And to speed up this process for all the other images, you can click on motion and then press Ctrl and C to copy the effect. Now drag the second image above the first one and then with the layer selected, press Ctrl and V to paste the position and scale values. You can now simply change the second position value to move the image down a bit. Then drag the third image above the second layer and then paste the effects again and then move it down a bit and repeat this with all images. Now to create the smooth move in animation like MrBeast, you need to go to effects and then search transform and then apply the effect to the sequence. And in effects controls, make sure you're at the 1 second mark and then click on the stopwatch next to position to create a keyframe. Now move to the start of the clip and then change the position value so that the image is off screen. To make the end animation, you need to move to about the 3 second mark and then create a keyframe for the current value. Then move forward about 1 second again, and then move the image off screen. To smoothen out the animation, you can select the keyframes, right click, temporal interpolation, ease in, and then select ease out. For an even smoother animation, you can expand the arrow next to position to open up the speed graph. Now click on one keyframe to show these blue handles, and then you can drag the right handle a bit to the left, so we get this peak at the beginning of the animation, which means it will be fast in the beginning and then slower towards the end. On the last keyframes, you can do the opposite. A slow curve in the beginning and a fast run towards the end. And you can also set the shutter angle to 360 to add some motion blur to the animation. And this is what we got so far. To apply the animation to the images, you can click on the transform effect and then copy it. Now select only the image above the sequence and then paste the effect. And this is because, as you can see, the image is not entirely off screen, so we need to tweak the position keyframes a bit. So with the image layer selected, go to effects and tools and then move the player to the first keyframe, which should be at the start of the clip. Now change the position value so the image is hidden, and then move to the last keyframe using this arrow, and then move the image so it's off screen again. Now you can click on the transform effect and then copy it, and then you can select the other images in the timeline and then paste the effect onto it. And this is what we got. Now to avoid animating in all images at the same time, you need to make sure you're at the start of the clip and then hold shift and then press the right arrow key to move forward 5 frames. Now move the first image to the playhead, then move forward 5 frames again, and then align the second image with the playhead, and keep offsetting each image 5 frames. And we now got this animation like MrBeast. And if you want to reveal a different person, you can simply select all the layers and then hold Alt or Option Mac and then drag it to the side to duplicate it. Now in the project panel, select the sequence with the person you want to reveal, and then you can simply right click and replace the sequence with the one from the bin. And if you want, you can also move the sequence down and the image up. And also, don't forget to replace the duplicate image with a different person. We have now created this MrBeast flip animation, and you can find the project file in the description below.